So something that we get asked every day is, can you spray foam my existing walls? The answer is yes and no. Okay, let me explain. First of all, spray foam is a specific type of application of foam insulation. It's being sprayed on. This is usually done in any kind of open area like an attic or a crawl space or a new built house. You can picture it because it's being done like spray paint typically. Now, I say no because spray foam usually is not done in existing walls. However, injection foam is done in existing walls, and the main difference for there is injection foam is a low to non-expanding foam insulation that is installed through a hose that's placed inside of a closed cavity, like an existing wall, and then it's injected into that cavity. So let's go through the steps of what it would take to insulate an existing wall. So if you have, let's say, siding, like vinyl siding, aluminum siding, what we do is take a strip off about halfway up the wall, and then we drill into the cavity, and we actually place a Slim Jim in the cavity, feel for every single stud, and we drill a hole in every stud cavity. Now, we make sure that we feel for every stud cavity. We don't just drill every 16 or 18 inches. You'd be surprised how many houses are out there with a 2 or 4 inch cavity that could easily be missed. So once we do that, we inject every single cavity. We go from the bottom to the top with foam. If there's existing insulation in there, that's no problem at all. It's usually fiberglass batts. What'll happen is that injection foam, as it's being pumped in, will just compress that fiberglass bat, and then foam will fill up the rest of the space inside that cavity. Now, if you have brick, for example, don't worry, it can still be done. What we do is we just drill in the mortar joints into the stud cavity, 3 levels, at the bottom, middle, and top of every single stud cavity. And then, same thing, we inject from the bottom, we inject from the top, we place a marker in that middle hole so that we know that foam has reached from the bottom and from the top. Once we do that, we top off in the middle there, and then we re-mortar those holes. Now, there's also the option of going from the inside of the house, like through the interior drywall or plaster. Obviously, this is a more invasive process. A lot of homeowners don't like this just because, you know, you'd have to move everything around. It's already a noisy process with the drilling. So being in the house, it can be, you know, a little bit more invasive. So most people don't go for that, but it is an option. Specifically, if you have, you know, some type of exotic exterior on the house, like a lot of older houses might have slate or stucco or something like that, that you don't want drilled into, or even some type of wood that's very decorative. So going from the inside is an option. But again, wood, stucco, slate, we can deal with those as well. Each one's a little bit different. Wood, a lot of times it can be taken off. A lot of times we would just drill through it and put a wood plug in there. Most people would just paint that over. But again, inside's an option if you don't want that drilled through on the outside. So if you're asking yourself, you know, I'm feeling drafts, my walls are always cold, but it's an old house, do I have any options? Absolutely. Your exterior walls can easily be re-insulated with injection foam. Hope this information's been helpful to you. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, drop a comment, tell us you know, about an experience when you had your exterior walls, your existing exterior walls insulated. And always hit that bell so you get all of our notifications. If you like more of this video and you want to see more of this, go to our channel. We got all the videos, or at least some of them. Guys, please subscribe to the channel. Seriously, this production is not cheap. We have to pay like 4 people to make this happen. I didn't wake up looking this good.